We're smack dab in the middle of the Sooner State. Norman, Oklahoma, the site for today's football matchup. And now let's head down to the coin toss, and it's brought to you by Coke Zero. Real Coca-Cola taste and zero calories. Enjoy everything. Both teams have sent their special teams onto the field, and we're ready for the opening kickoff. Sends it sailing downfield. He's to the 20. And down he goes at the 25-yard line. Mayfield's coming out for the first time, home field. He loves the spotlight, and this crowd is amped right now, Kirk.
Brad, we've seen over the years guys who have a chance to play at home, how they seem to play better. But this crowd's been anticipating this the entire week, and now it's right here before them. I tell you, I think he's having an effect not only on his own offense, but his own defense, and even this crowd. You talk about a difference maker, that's what this young man really is.
The quarterback didn't see anybody open downfield, so he took it himself and picked up some decent yardage.
So the quarterback draw gets back to the line of scrimmage.
Boy, the senior linebacker's experience really showed on that run. He sniffed it out perfectly and made the tackle.
They'll spread the field with five wide. Passes to the left, and it's going the other way. He's at the 40. He's taken down right around the 32-yard line. Spectacular play there by the linebacker to come away with that interception.
I don't even think the quarterback saw him on that play. He was right there waiting for the ball.
From the 32-yard line, first down. And they make the stop around the 36-yard line.
There are a lot of players in the college game that can make something happen when the blocking breaks down. But when it's that bad, I don't care who you are, you're going down for a loss.
Here comes the pressure. Just throws this one away. The defense got some pressure and forced a bad pass.
I think they've been a little bit more aggressive here with their pass rush, and that time it paid off with an incompletion.
Third down, 14 yards to go. Ball on the 36.
Even though they didn't sack him, the pressure was still enough to force a bad pass. If you can get in there and disrupt the pocket, then the quarterback is going to have a tougher time getting the ball to his playmakers.
Texas El Paso is looking to go up by three. He gets it up, and he missed it right. No good.
You know, for a second there, I thought it might hook back, but it just kept slicing to the right. That's a tough break.
The quarterback comes back on the field, and I'm sure he's hoping to make up for that interception on the last drive.
He can't dwell on the interception. There's still a whole lot of football to be played today.
They'll bring him down around the 49-yard line.
What we're seeing right now is just a great connection between the quarterback and his receivers. They make these plays look effortless.
He's scrambling. He's going to take off. And down he goes, right around the 34. And he has a huge game.
Yeah, I like the decision-making ability of this quarterback. He looks and looks. He sees nothing. He didn't get rattled. He sees some green in front of him, and he takes off. Ends up with a great run.
Throws it into coverage, and it's intercepted. Was a dangerous pass.
Well, you should have known better than to throw that football into coverage like that. You can't expect the receiver to come down with that ball.
First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 36-yard line. Brought down after a nice run up the middle.
Too easy. down at about the 39-yard line.
The thing about the option is you're going to have some negative plays, but if you keep running it, it'll create some big play opportunities.
We've got third and eight. Ball on the 39-yard line. Always a noisy place to play and tough on the offense. Under heavy pressure. He wants it all going long. Johnson was the intended target on the play. They're going to be forced to punt it away here.
The defense held their ground on that play. The quarterback just wasn't able to find any open receivers.
Luna is the punter. And they push him out at the 38. Let's get some points going right now. Not a lot of offense here in the opening quarter.
I'm with you. I'd like to see a lot more offense than we've seen up to this point. Give credit to the defenses, but I think you're going to see both these offense coordinators get more of a feel for things and start to adjust their play calling.
Their last drive ended with an interception. We're about to find out what the defense can do this time.
He's got a lot of time to forget about that last pick. He's just got to stick to the game plan.
Quick throw. Tackle made right around the 46-yard line. He throws left. Oh, boy, almost intercepted.
Well, you want to do everything you can to keep the ball out of the hands of these receivers, so that was a really good effort.
Second down, 10 to go. Ball on the 46-yard line.
16's coming. Check Mike. Check Mike.
Here we go. And he's taken down at the 33. Superb effort by the receiver to come down with that ball.
Well, this comes down to the timing between the quarterback and the receiver, and the result, again, a nice play for the offense.
Fires quick, he catches another. He's tackled at the 24-yard line. Catches it, and he's immediately tackled behind the line. Drop back a yard.
Really, they just had nowhere to go after the catch.
It's third down, and they're about 2 yards shy of the sticks. Nice run, and he's brought down. Sheds that one. They'll get him for a loss. He's got the corner, and he's tackled at the 15-yard line. Into the halfback on the screen. Tackle at the 9-yard line.
That's a key play to find the open man and keep the drive alive.
He's on the run. He's taken down at the 5. Looks like he flinched down there on the line.
You got to be careful to avoid these. Penalties are a great way to stall out a drive.
From the 10-yard line, it's second down.
Red 2, yellow, easy, easy. Blue 20.
Tackled after a decent pickup. Anderson gains about 4 yards on the play.
Roger, Roger. Mike three.
They'll line up with five wide receivers. He scrambled. And they make the stop. Around the 5 yard line. Mayfield picks up a yard on the scramble. Fourth down. This should be an easy field goal. Kicks up. And the field goal is good.
Even though they gave up a field goal here, that defense is feeling pretty good about themselves right now. It could have just as easily been a touchdown.
He really got a hold of that kick. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. Oklahoma's looking awfully impressive right now in defense, but we are in the first quarter.
Yeah, this is about as dominant a first quarter that we have seen in a long time. But let's see if they can continue to play this well throughout the rest of the ballgame.
And while they are behind, they know they can knot things up in a heartbeat. It's way too early to change your game plan. Nice run up the middle. Second down and five. Ball on the 30. Throws complete. He's got room to work. He's out of bounds at the 33-yard line. These fans are showing you why teams hate to come here, folks. They get nice yardage on that run.
Very effective play calling in a third down situation. It's plays like that you need to win ball games. Convert on third down.
First and 10. Ball on their own 37. He makes it to the 38-yard line. After one, this game's still pretty close. Oklahoma's got a 3-point lead. Back to the action here in the second quarter. It's been a good one and a tight one at this point. They go with him again, and he'll be taken down behind the line.
Really good play here in run support by the linebacker. The big guys up front took away the running lanes, and he was able to get through for a loss.
And once again, they'll come to the line trying to convert on third down. It's arguably the loudest crowd in the nation, and they are turning it up a notch. He fights forward to about the 36. Jones is the deep man awaiting the return. He punts it away, and it's a great kick. He's out to the 30. He's pushed out of bounds at the 41.
Momentum swings have been fairly even. And with so little separation, this game can be drastically changed on just one or two plays.
Oklahoma holds a field goal lead. Now he's scrambling. They'll bring him down at the 43. Five guys will be out in the pattern as they're in the shotgun. Hauls that one in, and down he goes, right around the 42-yard line. Scrambling around, runs with it, and he's got room. Brought down around the 37-yard line. he's got the first. He's going to try and scramble. Tackle made
at about the 23-yard line.
The quarterback trying to make a play.
Well, he did a nice job of getting some yards there on the scramble, but he needs to learn to slide to avoid those big hits.
From the 23-yard line, second down. Got some open field. Makes it out to about the 13. Oklahoma has a three-point lead. He fights forward to about the 10. Got some open field. Huge play, and it's going to be first and goal. He tries to buy some time. Decides to take it himself, and he's got it. Touchdown. So the quarterback decided to improvise and took it in for the touchdown.
This is why this guy is such a special player. This is what makes the offense even more difficult to stop. When a quarterback can take it himself and run, that's just one more weapon the defense has to account for.
And he hits the PAT.
So a 10-play, 57-yard drive, and they put up 7 points.
Looks like they're ready for the kick.
The Sooners saw one of their key guys go down earlier, but it looks like he might be able to get back in the action.
This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback.
You think about the challenges these two teams are facing. On one side, you've got to find a way to keep building on your lead, and on the other side, you've got to find a way to get back in it.
And he has it on the corner. He makes it to the 25-yard line. The running back gets a yard, maybe less.
He was playing the run all the way and was able to stop him quickly. Good job by that senior safety.
From their own 25-yard line,
it's second down. And he tackles him hard at the 34.
Very solid gain through the air. I'm impressed with the poise of this quarterback and the ability of the receiver to keep his concentration and get his hands on the football.
Listen to this place.
They run left and he'll lose yardage.
Luna awaits the snap. He makes it out to maybe the 36-yard line.
And offense is back on the field after running the ball very well on their last drive.
This offensive line really opened up some big gaps for the running back last time.
Got him.
Coaches don't like it when their quarterback gets hit like that. And don't be surprised to see the old coach get on his lineman to protect the quarterback a little bit better.
The Sooners taking their first time out of the half.
2 minutes left in the half. Slings it. Catches it, and he's looking for more. That tackle could have saved a very big play.
Kill.
huge play, and now they're in a great position to score.
First down.
Defense trying to hold their ground here. It's first and goal inside the five.
They hit him in the backfield.
Good discipline here by the defense, stringing the option out and plugging the running lanes. That moved him back.
Mike 16.
Roger. Watch two.
Here we go.
He's scrambling. And he's going to run this one in. Touchdown.
You know, he was looking and looking, and he finally said to himself, you know what, I'll just take this thing myself. Nice decision making.
And he tacks on the extra point.
So a 5-play, 63-yard drive, and they get it in for 7.
Brad, I thought that was a textbook drive. I thought they did a really good job of showing balance, mixing the play calling with the run and the pass. Just an overall well-executed touchdown drive.
And he got all of this one. Great kick. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback.
Things are on the verge of getting out of hand before we even hit the half. These next few drives are going to go a long way in determining what kind of game this will end up being.
And he's taken down
right around the 34.
They pick up good yardage that time on the pass play.
Here they kind of put pressure on the quarterback and challenged him to find the hole in the defense. And in this case, he did. Nice job.
Makes the catch, and the defense is all over him. They bring him down for a loss.
That's a loss of about 3.
They really just didn't have any room to work on that play. The defense just suffocated him there.
They're about 4 yards away here on third down. You expect this every time you're here, and you're never disappointed. This crowd is amazing.
Throwing right.
Can't ask for much more than a 3-and-out. Great job, defense.
The defense looks like they're going to send in the cavalry on this one.
Jones fields it at the 27, and he's shoved out of bounds at the 37. Mayfield's ability at that quarterback spot, we all knew about that, Kirk. We thought he was going to have a good game. He's not disappointing us at all. We're closing in on halftime, and right now he's having an effect on the entire game and especially on his team.
Yeah, and Brad, he's really just sparked this entire offense, and I think his success has a lot to do with the momentum that this team's been able to enjoy. And this is exactly what the coaching staff have counted on, is his ability to lead this team and make plays like this to be able to lead them to a victory. It takes a special player to be able to do it, and so far we've seen that from him.
Slides down to the ground.
Hey, kill! Flare!
Take the creep!
Throws into cover, it just picked off.
There we go.
Just when it looked like this offense might be able to put this game out of reach, you turn the football over with an interception? Boy, this could come back in a big way to bite you.
From their own 32-yard line, it's first down. And he's tackled right away. The slant pattern, good for about 8 yards on the play.
The Miners call a timeout. That's their second of the half.
First down grab. He's tackled right around the 48-yard line.
Easy. Big dog. Ready. 3 from 5. Jack. Easy.
Gets it out quick, and it's going the other way.
You're
Brad, I'm going to put that one on the quarterback. I think he's forcing the issue out there. I understand you're down a couple scores and you're trying to get back into the game, but you can't get it all back at once. You've got to be patient, take your time, and methodically work yourselves back as a team back into this game.
I guess he'll throw this one as far as he can and hope for a miracle. He zips it out to the left. Intercepted. We've played a half. The Sooners lead 17-0.
We've played 30 minutes. Glad to have you with us on the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. David Pollack and I here in the studio to break down everything that just happened in your game. Neither ground game very productive in that first half, David, and I really think it came down to each player on the defensive side executing their assignments and trying to get the positive self-determination that they wanted from a defense.
No doubt about it. And you look at the defenses doing such a great job stopping the run. That's the first thing that you do 99% of the time in meetings is, what are we going to do first? Stop the run. Because that's usually the place where you can get gashed the most. It's the simplest. Quarterbacks don't have to go back and make reads. It's designed. You know what they're going to do. But it also comes down to the big boys up front and those big boys making holes. And right now, I don't see many holes. And I don't care if you have Barry Sanders. I don't care if you have the best running back of all time, whoever it is in your backfield. If there's not a hole, there's no yards to be made. There's nothing they can do. So the defensive line doing a great job stuffing the run.
That'll do it here in the studio at halftime. We'll try to see if Pollack can bring a little energy in the second half. Got a lot of games to watch, including yours. Brad and Kirk, ready for the second half.
Welcome back, everybody. Second half action about to begin. He sends this one deep. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. Oklahoma's continuing to play extremely tough defense. This has been impressive.
It's just been impressive to watch them play with such an attitude, almost a chip on their shoulder with the energy that they're playing with. I think it's going to require that kind of effort to be able to win this game.
There's got to be some sense of urgency to this offense right now. They don't have the luxury of wasting drives if they want to get back in the game. Gets to about the 27-yard line. From their own 27-yard line, it's second down. They come out in a goal line set. Tackle at the 28-yard line. They're one of the loudest crowds in the country, and they are on their feet. Complete and he stopped immediately. Luna is waiting for the snap. And he just got stood up right there. And for Mayfield, it has not been an easy ride in this one.
He's made a lot of mistakes up to this point. But you know what? He's got a track record. And I think, I believe personally in watching him, that he has the ability to turn this game around and to finally get into his rhythm and get this offense going.
Still a lot of time to make amends. The quarterback leads the offense back out onto the field as we get set to resume play. Gets it out in a hurry. And he went way up, and he's got the interception. He's taken down at the 39.
They're giving away 3 yards and only making life easier for the guys on the other side of the ball.
First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 46-yard line. Up the middle for a nice gain. The stop right around the 46-yard line. So it's third down, and they've got about 2 yards to go. They can't hear a thing down there. Here's a handoff, and he's brought down right away.
He just never had a chance to get any running room. The defense was on him almost as soon as the ball was snapped.
The Miners had one of their key players go down earlier, but it looks like he might be able to get back in the lineup. Trying to change the field position with his kick. Booming kick. Little too much leg into that punt. They'll bring it out to the 20. Both squads are digging in now. Let's see what happens on this next drive. Going right to his tailback. And he's tackled at about the 29-yard line. Very good tackle in space. Caught with room to work, and he is drilled at the 33.
Watch two, watch two. I'm here all day.
Easy, easy.
They'll bring him down at the 34-yard line. The 46-yard line.
By three. Bumble. There.
Here we go.
Check. Dancer.
He makes it out to maybe the 49-yard line. It's second and seven. Ball on the 49-yard line. The delay, and he's brought down immediately. This is the eighth play of this drive.
Hey, pick your game up.
Mike 19.
Delivers to the halfback on the screen. Brought down in the open field. Incomplete. From the 40-yard line, second down.
Red two.
Now he's scrambling. And down he goes around the 29-yard line. On the screen. He's knocked out of bounds around the 8-yard line. Tackle made at the 6-yard line.
Across the middle, caught it, touchdown. And he converts the extra point.
So a 13-play, 81-yard drive, and they come away with a touchdown.
Oklahoma lines up for the kickoff. Nice kick, plenty of distance. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. UTEP's having a hard time doing anything on offense right now.
Well, they've had some opportunities, but they either turn the ball over or obviously don't execute on third down and they're forced to punt. Or their drive ends up stalling in a fourth down. But they're moving the ball at times. I think they've just got to take some chances at this point late in a game like this. Throw the ball downfield and hope that your receivers can make some plays.
We've got a second and 11. Ball on the 24. Throws quick to the receiver and it falls incomplete. Going to bring up fourth down.
The defense held their ground on that play. The quarterback just wasn't able to find any open receivers.
Jones is the deep man awaiting the return. Jones fields it at the 34. He goes out of bounds at the 45-yard line.
The last time out, they were able to pick up big chunks of yards through the air. You wonder if they'll go back to that same strategy or will they start to lean a little bit more on their ground game.
He's going to try and scramble. And he's taken down around the 48-yard line. They need about 3 yards to get the first here on second down. Makes it out to maybe the 46-yard line.
I can't believe they let you play. I can't believe they even let you play. 16.
He fights forward to about the 43. One more quarter to play, and this one appears to be well under control. Oklahoma's got a 24-point lead. All right, we're just about set to start action here again in the fourth quarter. He's tackled around the 35-yard line. It's second down, and they're about 2 yards away from the sticks.
Mike three.
They'll line up with five wide receivers. He's scrambling. He dives, and he'll be marked down. Around the 27-yard line. Second and seven. Ball on the 27.
16, check mark.
And he carries the ball for a nice game. And this is the eighth play of the drive.
Mike three, Pumble.
gets out to around the 12. From the 12-yard line, first down. Nice play to set up first and goal. Here's play number 10 on the drive. Touchdown, OU. And he tacks on the extra point. A nice 10-play, 54-yard drive, and they put up 7 points. They line up to kick this one away. He kicks it off, and he got all of that one. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback.
The Sooners have really been all over the place. They're playing like a defense possessed.
I love to watch a defense just pin its ears back and just fly to the football. They are playing with a reckless attitude, and it's really paid off because it set up their offense to be able to score points.
I don't expect any once-in-a-lifetime rallies here, but that being said, we could still see some exciting plays.
Throws it in a hurry. Knocked out of bounds at the 28. Second down and 7. Ball on the 28-yard line. Fires it out. And he's shoved out of bounds right around the 34. He's hit and taken down. From their own 46-yard line. First down.
Right here. Mike 14.
Tackle at the 45.
Nice play, baby. Nice play. Let's go, defense. Our time. It's our time. 14's the mic. 14's the mic.
Caught, and he steps out of bounds. Johnson gains 4 yards on that reception.
And they're moving the ball well because this quarterback hasn't thrown an incompletion yet on this drive.
From the 41-yard line, it's first down. He's got it with room to run. Good open field tackle. Less than 3 minutes in the game. Fires quick out to the receiver, and he can't make the grab. And this play is number 8 on the drive. Quick throw, and he's got his man again. And they push him out at the 25-yard line.
A quarterback's best friend is a receiver he can count on to catch the ball every time he drops check, back the pass. Right.
From the 25-yard line, first down. And they got it.
I think this defensive end is doing a great job of getting after the quarterback, not only with the sack in this case, but it seems like the entire game he's done a good job of creating pressure, making this quarterback feel him, and almost giving him happy feet back there. He doesn't seem to be in rhythm and almost seems to be throwing the football, feeling the pressure and almost creating nerves on the quarterback.
10th play of the drive.
Hey, defense, let's go. Mike 9.
Here we go. And he hits him hard at the 30. They've been 2 for 2 on third downs in this drive, and they'll try to convert again here. As a man, he'll lose big yards. A 4-yard loss.
Well, that's just a sound play by the defense. They dropped him well short of the line of scrimmage.
Fourth and long.
Not much you can do there. You got to go for it and give yourselves a chance.
Both teams are playing out the stretch here. You want to get experience for guys who normally don't get in the game and try to avoid injuries.
Less than 2 minutes in the fourth quarter. Here's the handoff, and he's taken down for a loss.
Sometimes a play is not going to work for whatever reason. Doesn't mean you throw the play away. You just need to execute better next time.
From their own 33-yard line, it's second down. They'll drop him for a loss. He's to the 40. He's at midfield. He's pushed out of bounds at the 46.
Terrific execution by the entire offense to make that run work and to get the third down conversion.
Anderson gets a carry left side. They bring him down in the backfield.
Well, you think about receivers coming over the middle taking shots from the safety, but a runner who's still in the backfield, this guy just flies all over the field.
Today we saw a game that wasn't even close. 31-0, Oklahoma. Thanks for joining us for another game of NCAA Football 14. For Kirk and everyone here at EA Sports, Brad Nussler saying goodbye, and we'll see you next time.